Welcome to MCN and Ducati's brand new Scrambler Cafe racer. This is Ducati's latest Scrambler evolution. This one's the Cafe racer, and it's kind of based on the generic Scrambler platform, which is a 75 horsepower V-twin engine, 803cc. But to make it a cafe racer, they've put 17-inch wheels on the bike. They've given it all the nice little cafe racer twigs, clip-ons, short mud guard, and a styling update, really. You'd be forgiven for thinking that this is just like a facelift, a styling job. But with the 17-inch wheels and the suspension mods that this bike's got, it actually rides a lot differently to the normal Scramblers. You know, you've got things like desert sleds and all the kind of more retro looking bikes. Whereas this actually does ride like a nice little sports bike. It's not too overpowering. The engine's got just the right amount of power for town riding. You can have some fun in the bends, and the chassis is actually really good as well. It handles really nicely, got lots of grip, really good brakes, excellent ground clearance. It's actually really, really surprised me. Definitely more than a styling job. I mean, the styling is fantastic. You'd look at it and be the cynical among you might think, you know, it's just got some clip-ons and number plates, but what Ducati have done have actually evolved this bike into something that's properly sporty and more than just something to look at. Rivals to this bike would be things like the BMW R9T Racer, the Triumph Street Cup, and the Yamaha XSR Abarth, those kind of retro cafe racer style bikes. Things like the Thruxton R are probably a bit too powerful for this bike. But among those bikes, and we've recently done a group test actually, the Scrambler actually came out top. Because it's so friendly, it's so easy to ride, it kind of ticks all the boxes. It's got the performance, which is enough for experienced riders, but not too intimidating for new riders. It's got good comfort, really nice build quality, nice style, whereas the other bikes it's up against, the Triumph probably isn't powerful enough to compete with the Scrambler, and the BMW and the Yamaha have just got brutal, extreme riding positions. But I think overall, and you'd never believe it until you tested them all back to back, the Scrambler Cafe Racer's actually the best of the bunch. Favourite feature for me was the fact that the bike doesn't take itself too seriously. It's quite easy to get caught up with bikes wanting more power and better electronics and better suspension and all this kind of stuff. But the Scrambler is basic, but in a nice way. So you don't feel under any pressure to ride it fast. You know, it does give you thrills and enjoyment, and you can ride it quite hard. But I like the fact that it's equally as good as just, you know, rolling down your favourite road at sane speeds and enjoying the scenery. I like the quality of it. I like the soundtrack. I really like the styling as well. I love those gold wheels and the black paintwork. Kind of reminds me of the old JPS paint jobs. Overall verdict is I'm really, really impressed. The bike isn't cheap. Today's money, it's about $9,000. So, you know, it's not that affordable, but you do get a lot of bike for the money. And if you're in the market for something that really looks the part, but rides really well as well, then I think the Cafe Racer would be right up your street.